हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। सो आज हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं व्हाट इज केमिस्ट्री, बिकॉज़ ये वीडियो उन लोगों के लिए है जो अभी अभी 11th स्टैंडर्ड में आए हैं और जिन्हें केमिस्ट्री के बारे में बहुत कंफ्यूज है, वो उन्हें एग्जैक्टली पता नहीं केमिस्ट्री क्या है। तो आज इस वीडियो में हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं केमिस्ट्री एग्जैक्टली क्या होती है, उसके बाद हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं कि 11th स्टैंडर्ड में महाराष्ट्र बोर्ड के क्वेश्चन में कौन से टॉपिक्स है, उनके सीईटी में क्या वेटेजेस हैं, and most important हम जे पेपर एनालाइज कर रहे हैं। ओके, सो लेट्स गो फॉर इट। इंट्रोडक्शन टू केमिस्ट्री, द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग व्हिच इज सीन ऑन योर स्क्रीन इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू केमिस्ट्री। तो आप लोगों ने क्या, आप लोगों को क्या पता है व्हाट इज केमिस्ट्री? आप लोगों को बहुत सारे कंफ्यूजन होते हैं जब हम 10th स्टैंडर्ड तक होते हैं कि व्हाट इज केमिस्ट्री? इज केमिस्ट्री रिएक्शंस? इज केमिस्ट्री केमिकल्स? इज केमिस्ट्री फॉर्मूलास? सो मैं आपको आज बताने वाली हूँ कि व्हाट एग्जैक्टली केमिस्ट्री इज ऑल अबाउट। सो द केमिस्ट्री इज ऑल अबाउट द मिक्सचर ऑफ रिएक्शन, केमिकल्स एंड फॉर्मूलास। सो बेसिकली केमिस्ट्री मेन ब्रांच इज सब डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स: फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री, इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एंड ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। नाउ दीज टर्म्स मे बी न्यू फॉर यू बिकॉज 10th स्टैंडर्ड तक ये सब आपको बाइफर्केटेड नहीं था, आपको सब एक साथ था। But now you need to understand what is the actual difference between physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry and organic chemistry. Physical chemistry, it is basically the chemistry, the definition is on your screen, but let me try to simplify again. Physical chemistry is all about the experiments, then using formulas, the experiments by measures of physics, but using केमिकल्स। तो हमें केमिकल्स यूज करना है और हम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स करते हैं, हम उसको फॉर्मूला में सब्स्टिट्यूट करते हैं, हम लॉज प्रूव करते हैं इसमें। सो फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री इज मोर रिलेटेड टू फिजिक्स, द नेम इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट, राइट? द सेकंड वन इज इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। इनऑर्गेनिक, इट्स द नेम आल्सो सजेस्ट हियर दैट इट इज ऑल रिलेटेड टू इनऑर्गेनिक, दैट इज मेटालिक कैरेक्टर्स, मेटालिक एलिमेंट्स। So this inorganic chemistry deals with extraction, mining, purification and many other things. You will mostly learn in inorganic chemistry about the all the elements in the periodic table with respect to their blocks. Okay, the third one and the very vast is the organic chemistry. Organic chemistry हमें पता है बिकॉज हम ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री बचपन से प्रैक्टिकली देखते आए हैं। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, हम जब थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड में थे हमें तभी पता था कि व्हाट इज ऑक्सीजन। हमें स्कूल में बताया गया था कि वी ब्रीद इन ऑक्सीजन। सो ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन, वी आर वेरी वेल वर्स्ड विद दिस वर्ड्स, ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड। हम हमेशा कहते हैं कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हमारी बॉडी से रिलीज होता है, ऑक्सीजन हम टेक करते हैं। सो दिस ऑल आर वर्क, इट्स एन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। So organic chemistry is very vast and it's simply with the carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen and all of them. So here you will be having more of the reaction mechanisms and it's really interesting. Inorganic chemistry is a kind of chemistry where you need to learn facts. For example, NaCl, where Na is electropositive and Cl is electronegative. So there is no rocket science in it. You have to learn it. You have to see the facts and then you have to move on. But organic chemistry, you have reasonings, you have mechanisms, you have various things here. It's very vast. And physical chemistry, as I told you, it's all related to physics. Let's go ahead. So these are the topics which you'll be looking forward in your 11th standard. So let me list them. Some basic concepts of chemistry, introduction to analytical chemistry, some analytical techniques, structure of atom, chemical bonding, redox reaction, modern periodic table, elements of group 1 and 2, elements of group 13, 14 and 15, states of matter, adsorption and colloids, chemical equilibrium, nuclear chemistry and radioactivity, basic principle of organic chemistry, hydrocarbons and chemistry in everyday life. So here, while seeing this index, I will tell you the last three topics, which is the basic principle of organic chemistry, hydrocarbon and chemistry in everyday life, is all related to your organic chemistry. the above one are all related to your physical chemistry. Then there comes model periodic table, elements, both the chapters for elements. These are related to your inorganic chemistry. So basically your 11th standard textbook and your 12th standard textbook is mixed up. So you need to understand what are the topics which are related to physical, inorganic and organic. Also here I have mentioned the weightage of the respective chapters in MHC. But these are my approximate analysis. So because the portion has been changed, so this is not accurate. But yeah, these numbers may change by one or two, but not more than that. So these are the analysis. So you need to figure it out that what chapters you need to start studying according to the marks given provided. Okay, so you can see the most number of questions are coming from element of group 13, 14 and 15. Because it's a block, it's a huge block, it's a P block, okay? So it's a huge block, it's have huge elements, many elements, more concepts. So obviously more questions are probable to come from this chapter. Basically you have to cover all these chapters because most of them are carrying high weightage, and to prepare CET, you need to study 12th, but you also need to study your 11th standard. So this was all about 11th standard topic. I hope it is clear. Okay, so this is JE main paper analysis. Okay, this is also my approx analysis, which I'm sharing with you all. So in organic chemistry, 10 to 12 questions. Inorganic chemistry, 5 to 7 questions. Physical chemistry, 8 to 10 questions. The paper pattern and the marking schemes is already discussed by Vivek sir in the previous video. You can check it out if you have missed it. So here you can see the clear analysis where organic chemistry is having more number of questions. That means more weightage. So in the earlier video, I have already mentioned that organic chemistry is very vast, okay? So if it is very vast, so it is carrying more weightage as well. So you need to focus on organic chemistry and physical chemistry more than inorganic chemistry. Let's get forward. So the easy topics. Now this is overall, not 11th standard. It is this chapter's list is considering of 11th as well as 12th topics. So the easy topic, it's like you can do it very quickly, is these chapters which are mentioned here. Chemical bonding, mole concept, atomic structure, electrochemistry, p-block elements, environmental chemistry, polymers, biomolecules, aldehyde, ketone, acids, metallurgy, coordination compounds, surface chemistry, chemistry in everyday life. So the chapters you're seeing right in front of your screens are the easy topics. So now you have understood that if these topics, I'll do it first. So it is easy for me to take MCQs faster because these topics are easy. It will take very few time to cover these topics. A month or 2 months or 3 months, that's it. Then you can focus on the topics which are long or which is more difficult. So this picture shows you about all your easy topics in your 11th and 12th with respect to your competitive exams. Moving on further, most important topics. Okay, so now here we have understood that what are the easy topics. Now we'll be learning about what are the most important topics, like which of the topics are having more weightage. So here we go. In organic chemistry, GOC, the general organic chemistry, is for 4 questions. There are 4 questions coming from this chapter. Then alcohol, phenols and ethers. From that chapter, there are 2 questions. Aldehyde, ketone and acids, 2 questions. Biomolecules, 2 questions. Physical chemistry, some basic concepts, states of matter, and equilibrium. From these chapters, 2 questions are compulsory to come from this part. Rest of the chapters like chemical bonding, solution, redox, kinetics, एक एक क्वेश्चन आ जाता है इसमें से. आगे देखते हैं इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. अब इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री में भी पी ब्लॉक, एज आई ऑलरेडी मेंशन दैट पी ब्लॉक इज अ ह्यूज ब्लॉक कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेनी एलिमेंट्स. सो बेसिकली मेनी एलिमेंट्स रिजल्ट्स टू मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट्स. सो देयरफॉर नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर टू. टी एंड एफ ब्लॉक एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स, दीस टू चैप्टर्स ऑल्सो कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट्स. सो या the chapters which are important, they'll have more number of questions. There are two questions from this. Metallurgy is very easy chapter. It's all about the extraction, purification, and all the uses of cores. So it is quite easy chapter, but the number of question is only one. S block, again, it's a block. It's a very small block. You'll come across this block as well. It's very easy. So the number of question is only one. Let's move further. Books to follow. So generally people are very much curious to have many books. They say we'll follow this book, we'll follow that book. But the one thing which you should stick to it is you should only follow NCERT. Okay, so this is the picture which you're seeing on your screen right now. The chemistry for part 1 is for 11, part 2 is for 12. In chemistry, physical chemistry, there'll be numericals for you, but numericals are not so difficult. Those numericals are related to all the concepts are related in this textbook. Organic chem ho gaya. Organic chem mein aapke paas just ek line. Matlab, you can't imagine a question with a direct line. Jo NCERT mein diya ho, the same question they keep in the competitive exam as well. This I'm talking for NEET as well. Okay. Or inorganic, though, I have already told you, it's all about facts. So you have to read it. So you can read it from here. In case you have finished reading this textbook, then what textbook, what more reference book you want to use are these reference books for inorganic, organic and physical. I have given some books here. But I'm telling you this, that once you take any reference book, in case, see if you have taken K. Kumar for inorganic, or you have another Singage, for example, for chemistry. And if you're reading it from starting, try to read it and complete that book. As in, you take many books, you sit together and start studying. This will create a mess. So what you have to do, you take a book and you start from A and complete it to Z. And then if you're not satisfied or you want more knowledge, then only you switch to another. Okay. So these are some references book here. Also follow NCERT. This is the Bible for you all right now. And next, if you want more books, more reference book, you can go through this. Or you have more good books, then you can go. These are some popular books which students generally refer, which I have mentioned here. So yeah, this was all about your JE analysis, MHCET, and your introduction to chemistry in 11th standard. If you have any doubt, any query, please comment in the comment section and please let me know. Thank you. Oh.